quick announcements. If you have lost anything, we do have a lock and down registration, so you can check back there. We have the after party. So after we wrap up everything today, we'll be meeting at the Museum of Man at 7 o'clock tonight for a fantastic after party. You won't want to miss it. You will need your badge to get in. We do have QR drinks, so bring your ID. We'll be checking those. And have a fantastic time. And I'll handle my call.
But, you know, when now there's like Kimmy and, you know, boxes are what really define continuous integration. So let's talk about those processes. The first one is what we call the build process, which really for WordPress code comes down to like, okay, I'm checking out code from my repository, you know, whether you have a team, a plugin, or just an entire WordPress site. This is really what defines more building for WordPress. So who here uses like SAS or yeah, so a lot of you. So pre-compiling, pre-processed CSS, JavaScript, all this stuff needs to be minified, either or converted to CSS. So that's part of your build process. Then you have testing. So testing can mean a lot of different things to people. Holy wars have been fought over testing, which type of testing is best, which one you should do first. But really in this context, more often than not, what we need is unit tests, the most basic ones that you can run, because you're really trying to catch errors and things like that. It also includes things like code quality checking, complexity checking, static code analysis, and things like that. Where things can differ a bit is this idea of deploying to a staging site and running acceptance testing. So who here is familiar with acceptance testing? Okay, so a few of you. So acceptance testing is this idea that your site's almost live. So you have like data in it that's like that's meant to simulate what's on the live site. And then you want to really test to see that the website is behaving the way it should using this kind of live data. So depending on how intense you do it, you can even copy your data from your production site to the testing site consistently. But the problem is that this is where things vary a lot for people because not everyone yet has a staging site. Who here has a staging server? Oh, actually there's quite a few of you. I'm really impressed. Because normally there's not a lot of hosting providers that come with staging sites. Who here uses something like Pantheon or WP Engine, the two that really stand out for having like staging sites? So these two hosting providers have staging sites. They're getting more and more common because they're useful also for just demoing stuff to clients and things like that. So a lot of the hosting providers do it. But on top of that, not everybody does acceptance testing either. So that's where the kind of, you know, where continuous integration of the implementation changes from one person to the other. Now, what do you need to do continuous integration? Because continuous integration can exist on its own. It's not like just a piece of software you install it, you're like, okay, I'm done. It actually like relies on other processes and tools to do this job. So the biggest one, it seems a bit obvious here to mention it, but you do need a version control system. So you need Git, you need SVN, everybody, right? So the faster this happens, the faster errors can get slip in. You know, you get a quick typo fix and actually you forgot to put a semicolon at the end and you just broke everything. Because you were like, you didn't even refresh the page. You were just like, oh, I'm just going to fix this, hit it, send it up, and then you didn't put a semicolon and you just broke the site. So you really don't want it to let it affect the quality of your code, because again, you make changes quickly, and you might be, oh, I'm just going to name this variable A, and I'll be done with this. And you want to catch these errors as well. So that's really the idea here, is you want to prevent these two specific types of issues with continuous integration. So this is our first question break. I don't know if anybody has questions so far. All right, that's fine. All right, so piecing it together. So I want to talk about two types of continuous integration workflows. So the first one I want to talk about is what I would call a local workflow, so just doing it on your own machine. So why would we want to do that? I mean, after all, we're talking about automation, about working as a team. Like, why would you want to do it on your own machine? Well, first of all, it's a lot easier to get it up and running. You can do it on your own machine, on your own time, you get it working, and then you don't have to, you know, sign up to a service, figure out how the service works, read all the documentation, connect your repository, all these things that we're going to see in a minute. So it lets you test these things on your own, and